What's up guys, in this tutorial, I will show you the best export settings for iMovie, which will allow you to view your project in high video and audio quality, as well as keeping a low file size. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. After editing your project, click on File in your menu bar and navigate to Share, File. On this window, rename your exported file if you want to. Under Format, make sure that Video and Audio is selected. Below, choose the best resolution for your video file. To get the highest possible video quality, set this option to 4K if it's available. Otherwise, set it to 1080p, which is still a great video resolution. If the 4K option is not showing up, then this is because your first clip imported to your iMovie project was in a lower resolution. You can fix this by importing a 4K video first, before starting the editing project in your timeline. While making changes to these options, you should see how your estimated file size changes too. I suggest setting the quality option to high. This allows you to preview and share the final video without inflating the file size by too much. Fast-moving videos, such as action camera or gameplay footage, should use a higher video quality. When setting this option to ProRes, which is a lossless video compression format, then your file size will increase by a lot, but it will allow you to keep most of the visual information to further edit the video in a different application, for example. You can also set this option to Custom. Custom allows you to use a slider to manually determine how large your file size will end up being in correlation to the video quality. Lastly, set the compress option to faster to export your video much quicker. This will decrease the video quality by a bit, but depending on which footage you are using, it will not make a huge difference. I like to keep faster enabled. Click on Next and choose a safe location before starting the rendering process. To further speed up the process for iMovie, you should prevent using too many applications at the same time. Close apps that you don't currently need to free up some resources on your Mac. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.